I've travelled to the USA, and more specifically the Consumer Electronics Show called CES in Las Vegas, and there's a ton of tech that you've probably never seen before, from TVs, robotics, and even gaming and that sort of thing. But there's a vehicle section with all the tech you could possibly want, and there's a few cool things this year which I want to share with you guys. Here's my favourites so far at CES 2025. Well, for starts, there's a lot going on here. I mean, look at the size of this hall alone. It's humongous. In fact, CES actually have about 4, 5, or 6 other halls with other things, but this is the one I'm most interested in, which is vehicle tech. And the first one on this list today is someone who you wouldn't actually suspect, and it's Amazon. Okay, so first one today, imagine being able to buy your car on Amazon and have it ready for collection the next day. Well, that's what Amazon have actually done, called Amazon Autos. This is actually live in the States now with one brand, Hyundai. Very clever concept, the fact that you can buy a car on Amazon. You have to let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Only available in the USA at the moment and only available with that brand, Hyundai. But interesting, I use Amazon a lot, so being able to buy your next car on there? Today. Let's see what they got. Yeah, having all the pictures on here, you can even do your finance application. It's just Amazon taking over. I like it. They didn't say they've got any plans to bring it out to the UK yet, but hey, it's cool to see these new things. What about the next one? Well, up next are a brand called Xperi, and they basically partnered with Mercedes and a few other brands where you can actually watch IMAX movies in the car. This does sound interesting. Basically, there's a new app that replaces Zinc. Now, Zinc used to be this thing where you could stream movies and watch content on the screen, and a few of you might be thinking, well, why on earth would you want to do that? Think about the future, as in the future, and quite fitting for where we are at CES. Basically, if cars are going to go autonomous in the future, or even electric, you might be waiting for it to charge for a little bit, you might want to put some content on your screen. This is where the new app Ridevu comes in. And I had a little demo in the very nice e-class here. Basically, what Xperi do here is they put IMAX enhanced content through the already impressive multimedia system and the surround sound in the car. So in this e-class here, for example, it has 3D surround sound and or the 4D surround sound with sound exciters. This is basically where the seat can vibrate to the kind of content you're watching. It is very, very immersive. I remember reviewing it on the e-class. Now, as this is an audio-based thing, very, very difficult for me to show off on camera here, but let me just say, it sounds like the best surround sound in a car possible. Kind of makes me want an e-class, not gonna lie. So basically, it's an audio format that's coming to new Mercedes-Benz, but this new app, as I said, replaces that Zinc service, so should be available in cars now, because I have been told, and I can confirm, it is available in the UK. So hopefully, I'll be able to try it in a few months' time when I get my hands on the Mercedes. So let me know, guys, if you'd like me to make a dedicated video on that. Well, that was fascinating. I would love all of that in my car. This one, this company called Gentex Corporation, have designed something that I think has not had any tech in this particular car piece at all. I'm talking about the sun visor. Well, and many other things, because on their stand they've got all sorts of things. Let's take a look. All right, now this is something I would love in my own car. We all know that problem where you're driving, especially in the winter, I will add, where the sun is very low, sun visor down, and you've probably got sunglasses on as well and you can barely see. What about a dimmable sun visor? Or even this concept where you've got like a head-up display through the sun visor? That's some pretty futuristic tech. This is why I picked this one out of some of the ones here to show, because this is quite cool. Now these guys also do loads of other things, from side mirrors and future tech in there to center mirrors with effectively like blind spot assist built into the actual mirror itself, and then of course OLED mirrors as well. I have actually seen similar stuff to this, although I don't think it was OLED tech. This was actually on a Mercedes-Benz Marco Polo non-UK spec that actually featured in the review that I did before. But yeah, interesting stuff. I wonder which one I would pick for my own car. Now, it is very, very hard to ignore self-driving cars. I know everyone kind of hears about this in the news and that sort of thing, that self-driving cars are coming and yet they're never here. But Waymo do actually do this. Yes, this is a real self-driving car that you can drive, sort of. I say drive, it drives for you. There's no driver. There is a steering wheel, as you can see here, but it does all of the driving. This is a truly autonomous car. Now, fun fact, I was actually going to experience this and actually be in one. I was about to say drive in one, but obviously you don't do the driving. I was actually going to fly out to Los Angeles, but sadly they actually had some kind of wildfires going on in like the Palisades. So my heart goes out to all of you who are affected. They do have operations in San Francisco and Los Angeles with Waymo, where they're driving around on the road. And I would like to experience it one day, because I bet it's quite unnerving when you do it for the first time. Now, one of the cars that Waymo use are Jaguar. I wonder how they feel about Jaguar's redesign they did recently. Maybe that's a sore topic. Now, up next, guys, is a company called SmartEye. And as you can see, I'm on the screen at the moment. And if I actually get a little bit closer, it is constantly tracking every aspect of what I'm doing, with my eyes on the road, to distractions, to pupil dilation and all sorts. Now, some of you might think, oh, this is a bit big brothery, but think about it. With autonomous cars coming, there is that transition period where, you know, the end goal is that cars will just drive you everywhere, which would be great. But in the meantime, there is that kind of thing where the car's going to take over certain aspects. So at what point does it know you're in control and when you're not in control? And this sort of tech here is a step in that kind of direction. Now, I guess the idea being as well, it can even detect if you've got your phone out. So notice some of the parameters over here now is saying I'm distracted over on the left-hand side, and it's kind of predicting where my hands are going as well, to the instrument cluster, to the multimedia system. So that's a lot of tracking. Is all of this necessary? I think so, with autonomous cars, you know, coming in the future, let's be realistic here, it's not arriving tomorrow or in a couple of years' time, at least I don't think so anyway. But yeah, if the car's gonna take over, it needs to know if you're paying attention. And tech like this will definitely do that. Another thing that comes to mind is privacy. What with everything we've just seen with eye tracking technology and LiDAR based systems and in-cabin monitoring systems and all sorts of things, privacy does come to mind. So when it comes to my kind of preferences and things like that, I'm actually quite open with what companies kind of use of my data, but I appreciate some people might not like that. So hopefully there's like an opt-in and opt-out sort of thing if that sort of tech appears in cars, or it's just used for the activation or deactivation of autonomous-based systems as and when that comes out. Of course, this is all futuristic, concept-y stuff in the future, but everyone's working on it. There's a lot of stuff here, and these are things to think about, because do you want your car monitoring you almost like Big Brother? Things to think about anyway. Okay, so Soundhound AI Automotive basically have a voice assistant that they work with car manufacturers. So say a car manufacturer doesn't have an amazing voice assistant and they wanted to put one in their car, these guys can help with that. Here's a few demos of how good it is.
It's really hot in here.
Decreasing temperature by 10 degrees Fahrenheit.
And we can take something that is very much a natural language query like that and interpret the implied intent, and I used the intensifier of really, so it turned it down a significant amount by 10 degrees. So how do I adjust my seat's lumbar support?
You can adjust the lumbar support by using the controls on the side of your seat. Just find the button that looks like a little back and press it.
My friend suggested that I visit the NFL stadium while I'm in Vegas. What is it called?
The NFL stadium in Vegas is called Allegiant Stadium. It's super cool.
Okay, but really what I want is to maybe see that on a map, which I could say, or I can just say, navigate there.
navigating to Allegiant Stadium. Follow the road.
Now notice the really, really cool thing here is that it can actually take in the contextual conversation of the one before. I don't think any car manufacturer voice assistant does that at the moment. Certainly my car doesn't do it, so hey Mercedes, and then hey BMW ones I've used before, and Volkswagen's one. I don't think any of them do it. There is ChatGPT integration with some cars, but that is quite cool, because that's not even using a large language model, apparently. I want that in my car. Now we've seen stuff on Mercedes, although they've been quite quiet on their multimedia system at the moment, which is going to be MBOS, which I can't wait to check out, which is going to be on the new CLA coming out this year. Hopefully I'll be one of the first to get it. But BMW have just announced a new multimedia system. Let's check it out. Whoa, it's bright out here. Right, BMW stand is over here. Because this is what it's like when you've been inside like all day. You can barely see anything. Right, let's go check this out. Basically, BMW have announced their latest iDrive system called BMW Panoramic iDrive. It has, of course, the main screen, which we've all seen before, but then tucked just beneath the windscreen is this. And guess what? It's customizable. To clarify, this does not replace the head-up display, that's available too, but there's four changes here. This, the BMW Panoramic Vision, BMW 3D head-up display, the central display, and the multifunction steering wheel, which is brand new, which cleverly show you icons based on when they're available. So for example, cruise control activation starting at a certain speed. I wouldn't mind checking this out in person, to be honest. Available soon, apparently as soon as a car has it, probably on whichever model they launch next, then every model after that will have the latest generation iDrive X. Well guys, that was an extremely busy show because there's so much going on everywhere, and these are just a few of the things that I've handpicked to show you guys here on YouTube. But yeah, let me know which one you're most excited about on cars in the future in many years to come. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, see you then.